today believes that one day there will be a state which will be a state of justice, where tyranny will be completely removed. If you look, for example, within Hindu thought, or within Zoroastrian thought, or within Jewish thought, or within Christian thought, or within Islamic thought, each one of these religions postulates a theory that there will one day be an ideal state, a state where there will be no poverty, a state where there will be no misery, and a state where a messianic figure will bring success for God's chosen people. And if you look within the religion of Islam, the idea is given within each and every school of the religion of Islam that the Mehdi will be the one who establishes the perfect state. This discussion is a contemporary discussion, not a historical one. Why? Because the belief in the Mehdi is a belief obligatory on every Muslim. Every Muslim in the world today, it's obligatory on them, according to their scholars, to believe in the Messiah that is the Mehdi. Yes, some believe he's born, and others believe he's yet to be born. But you must believe in him as the reality of someone who will bring justice to the earth. That's why we should be organizing conferences every year, where we invite every imam of every school in Islam, and we invite the leaders of other religions and tell them, come sit next to us, let us discuss our Mehdi, and let's discuss your Mehdi as well. Because don't think that in Hinduism or Sikhism they don't have a Mehdi. There is a Mehdi at the very core of the Indian subcontinent, a Messiah who will bring justice. It's a Muslim and a non-Muslim issue. Therefore, when we talk of this utopia, the builders right now are not all Muslims. The builders right now are any human being who is seeking to promote godly values on earth.